client over that hush payment made to adult film actress Stormy Daniels. But Giuliani's cleanup act is already raising new questions. Giuliani telling ABC News in a new interview this morning that Michael Cohen may have paid off other women if it were, quote, necessary. The former mayor is also stressing the hush money payment had nothing to do with the campaign.
I'm not an expert on the facts yet. I'm getting there. There is no way this is a campaign finance violation of any kind, nor was it a loan. It was an expenditure, and this expenditure would have been made whether he was running for president or he wasn't running for president.
This as President Trump faces new questions about his version of events. A New York Times report says the president knew about the hush payment to Daniels months before he denied knowing about it to reporters on Air Force One in April. Here to help us clarify some of these questions is the counselor to the president, Kellyanne Conway. Kellyanne, thanks so much for being here.
Thank you.
So the president's lawyer just told ABC News this morning that he didn't know whether President Trump had made similar payments to other women, but, quote, I would think if it was necessary, yes, Michael Cohen would have made similar payments. You were the campaign manager during that time. Do you know of any other payments like this one?
I do not. They didn't cross my desk as campaign manager. And I would also tell you that I'm happy to answer these questions, but I have limited visibility into what Mayor Giuliani is talking about because, politely, he is the president's counsel. I'm the president's counselor. I will tell you, though, in speaking with the president just yesterday, when the president said no on Air Force One, he was talking about he didn't know when the payment occurred. Mm-hmm. It's a very fast-moving exchange between him and Kathleen Lucy of the AP, I believe. And so he's saying he didn't know about it when the payment occurred. He found out about it after the fact.
All right, well, let's play this. Let's play the exchange if we can. This is in April, President Trump being asked by the AP, did you know about the $130,000 payment to Stormy Daniels? Let's play this exchange.
Sure.
So it's, did you know about the $130,000 payment to Stormy Daniels? No. So you're saying that he's saying he didn't know at the time.
At the time.
But then the next question, or a subsequent question, do you know where he got the money to make that payment? No, I don't know. That's present tense, but he did know.
You have to look at the president's three tweets. Again, I'm going to relay to you what the president has told me, which is the best I can do. He didn't know it at the time that the payment occurred. Separately, if you look at his three tweets this week, he said a lot in those three tweets on Thursday morning, Jake. I'm sure you have them or people can pull them up to themselves. It's democratization of information. The president tells everybody at the same time what's on his mind. In those tweets, he went back and repeated that this was a private arrangement and there was an NDA involved and that he is saying these are false claims and that Ms. Daniels and her attorney have violated that NDA. This is the president speaking. Mm-hmm. And the president says it's a very typical course of action for famous people or people who are wealthy. And the president has said that he did this to save his family the embarrassment. I will tell you, as the campaign manager for the winning part of the campaign, I was not made aware of this whatsoever. And I would push back on this whole notion that, well, what if this had come out before the final debate? All of it was out there. The president at the rallies.
The Stormy Daniels story wasn't out there.
Well, but there were all these, what the president referred to as false accusers. They had plenty of airtime here and elsewhere. They were lining up, and he would address them at his rallies. He was doing 6-7 different stops a day. And I will tell you, at the White House, when I show up to my job every day, this is not on my policy portfolio.
Those are different. First of all, you have more than a dozen women accusing the president of sexual assault or sexual harassment. That's different from a porn star who claims that she had a consensual affair with the president just months after the president's son was born.
Well, he's denied all of that. But the point I'm making to you is you're talking about a campaign.
Do you believe him? Do you believe that he did not have an affair with Stormy Daniels?
I believe, yes, he's denied it. So I have no reason to believe otherwise. I don't know. He has said he hasn't. But that's got nothing to do with my job in the White House, his job in the White House, or frankly, the campaign. Now, you've had the president, his lawyer.
If he made a payment so as to affect the campaign.
He has said he hasn't.
But they had this alleged affair in 2006, and he didn't pay her until October 2016. There's a decade there that he could have paid her.
He's telling you that he didn't pay her. His attorney did. I'm telling you that his attorney had discretion, as far as I can see. His attorney had discretion over funds and made the best call that he
had. When did the president find out that Michael Cohen had made this payment?
That I don't know, but I know that the president has said he didn't know it when it occurred, and that is the no on Air Force One. Now, respectfully, I know that CNN has invested a lot in this story, and in Ms. Daniels' attorney, Mr. Avenatti. He has appeared on your network over 65 times in less than 2 months. That's a choice that you make. But when I look at the CNN polling, Jake, I don't see this on there. I see the economy and immigration and health care. I see ISIS. I see historic talks in North Korea. We're on the precipice of ending decades of war between North Korea and South Korea, owing in large part to this president's leadership and him involving other leaders in that entire region. The JCPOA is coming up now, the Iran nuclear deal.
Yeah,
which
these are all issues we talked about and continue to talk about. And we would have liked to have, last week when the North Korea thing happened, we would have liked to have had Bolton or Pompeo on the show.
I hope they'll come
They refused to do the show. I do think it's important, though, whether or not the president of the United States tells the truth to the American people. And I'm sure you agree with me. The New York Times is reporting that the president knew months before the April denial that Michael Cohen had made this payment. This story broke in January. Michael Cohen made this payment. Are you telling me that President Trump, by April, still hadn't gotten to the bottom of it?
Let me repeat that the no refers to no at the time the payment occurred, which I read is in October of 2016. So the whole world found out about it, I guess, in January of 2018.
But the second question is, do you know where it was present tense? Do you know where the money from came from? And he said, I don't know. But we're being told now by the New York Times and others, including Rudy Giuliani, that the president did know. And it's important that the president tell the truth to the American people.
I think you want to look at the president's tweets where he says through reimbursement. You've got to look at his tweets because he responds to that. And that's honestly, Jake, that's the best I can do given my limited visibility in the legal matters and my very big visibility in the policy portfolio. And honestly, the great job this president is doing on many fronts that Americans tell those opinion leaders and pollsters they care about. You can't argue with a 3.9% unemployment rate. You can't argue with the lowest unemployment rate in so long among African Americans, if ever,
but
Hispanics.
But here's the
women.
Issue, Kellyanne. This week, the White House really started to lose the support of conservatives who want to support the president, who believe in President
Trump.
Numbers
are up among
the Wall Street Journal editorial board, very supportive of President Trump on everything except for trade, writes, quote, Mr. Trump is compiling a record that increases the likelihood that few will believe him during a genuine crisis, say a dispute over speaking with special counsel Robert Mueller or a nuclear showdown with Kim Jong-un. Mr. Trump should worry that Americans will stop believing anything he says. This is directly because of him not telling the truth, not being straight with the American people about this payment. And in addition, we've had people on Fox News Channel who are generally very supportive of the president saying to the president, to the television screen, you have to tell the truth. Stop doing this. You're eroding credibility. As the counselor to the president, aren't you concerned about this?
I'm concerned that you're not listening to the news I just broke, which is that the no refers to when the payment occurred. That's very important here. It was a fast-moving exchange. I asked the president what he meant, and he said, I didn't know about it when the payment occurred. I think you're overcomplicating that very simple point.
You think that answer was as honest and open? If that's the truth, that's the truth, he's saying, oh, I didn't know it at the time in 2016 when the payment was made. Do you think the president was as honest and transparent and open as he should have been? Because he could have said, I didn't know about it at the time, but subsequently I found out about it. And when he was asked, do you know where the money came from? Do you know, present tense, he could have said, yes, I reimbursed
him. But Jake, this is what always happens, is everybody has an idea about how the president should how he should speak, how she should answer, the words he
honestly,
should have used.
He spoke honestly.
He said no, which refers to when the payment occurred. But let's also be honest to your viewers, who you know full well, are so many of them are grateful that he's in that job because they have their job. I mean, you're denying the 5 million Americans who have received bonuses or raises or both because of a tax cut that your network continued to insist could never get through, and if it did, it would only benefit the wealthy. Go tell that to the people you and I grew up with outside of Philadelphia who are happy that he's the president because they have more disposable income. They left right.
We covered the tax cut, and I never said
not very much.
I covered the tax cut.
Small Business Week last week, 80% of small businesses have less tax.
Nobody undermines the president's message more than President Trump.
No,
President Trump puts out a tweet last week talking about how the unemployment rate is 3.9%, and he can't even stay on message in a 10-word tweet. By the end of it, he's talking witch hunt.
Well, maybe it's not your message, but his message is the 3.9%. That's the message Americans
need. So why does he undermine it with witch hunt?
Those facts and figures, I think Judge T.S. Ellis, great poet, T.S. Ellis in Virginia really said it best. He's not a political figure. He has no skin in this game except the law. And he really brushed back the Mueller folks by just saying, excuse me, have you burned through your $10 million budget yet? Mm-hmm. Where is this going? Because if this is actually to impugn or assault or indeed impeach or something else, the president, that's not what this was supposed to be about. A lot of Americans agree. And you know that I hear from people who didn't even vote for Donald Trump regularly,
right,
Jake, that they just want the guy to be able to have the space to do his job. And his job includes saying that the Iran nuclear deal was a bad deal from the beginning.
Does his job include lying to the American people? Do you think that his job includes lying to the American people? Because he continually does so, and he undermines his own administration when he does so.
Jake, he does many things. You just want that, respectfully, you just want that to go viral. You want to say the word President Trump and lie in the same sentence.
No, I would like him to stop lying,
quite
frankly.
Here's what doesn't lie. Here are some facts and figures that you should start treating your viewing audience to. The 20,000 new Apple jobs, if Tim Cook could have brought those to this country,
I understand you don't want to talk about the president's credibility.
Oh, no, I've already talked about it for 5 minutes.
Do you think there's a credibility crisis in this White House?
No, I don't, because I know that you have the screaming graphics that says it, but you had screaming graphics that talked about Russian collusion too. Those are gone, and now we're talking about this.
I don't know what's gone in terms of Russian
collusion. The sheer volume and velocity alone of what this president accomplishes and what he puts on the table in just one breakneck week. He's got a new Secretary of State who's out there saying his job as the chief diplomat for this country is to make sure Iran is never nuclear capable. And that's why this president has serious questions about the JCPOA. That's why when he struck Syria a couple weeks ago, we said it was also a message to Iran and Russia, who are helping Assad. Does it bother you at all that the American press corps says this president is not tough enough on Russia, and the German press corps in the East Room a week ago Friday asked Chancellor Merkel if she's concerned at how tough President Trump is being on Russia? People care that the regulations are lower. They care that Israel is in the crosshairs, our greatest ally.
And they also care, and they want the American president to tell them the truth.
We talked about that.
They want the American president to tell them the truth.
They know the numbers don't lie. They know 3.9%.
You keep talking about the unemployment rate, and it's fantastic.
Because it matters to people.
And we herald it. It matters to people, absolutely.
It matters to people. There are over 3 million new jobs created.
It also matters to people that the president tell them the truth.
He is telling the truth. When he stood up a week ago and said, guys, Sunday, America, Saturday is National Take Back Day. Bring in your unused, expired, or unwanted pills. And we collected a record number. You can fill up 3 Boeing 757s.
He went on Twitter and talked about the three American hostages. He talked about the three American hostages and how the Obama administration had tried and failed to get them free. 2 of the 3 were detained while Donald Trump was president. There is no way that Obama could have gotten them released because they were captured when Trump was president. That's just a lie, and that tweet is still up there. And that's just symbolic of the fact that this president gets in his own way all the time, even when there's something good potentially happening.
So you're focusing on the tweet, and we're focused on the hostages.
But why is he blaming Obama for hostages that were taken while he was president?
Jake, he's probably thinking about President Obama and the terrible Iran nuclear deal and the terrible what he did.
But why not just tell the truth? Or when
Korea.
Someone says
the truth is,
those two of those three were taken.
North Korea.
Two of those three hostages were taken when you were president. So maybe we should take down this false tweet.
And all three could well be released while he's president.
And God bless, and I hope that happens. But why lie about it?
Well, if you hope it happens, let's cover a little bit. Excuse me, let's cover.
I'm waiting for
it
to happen.
What do you think is the most important thing going on in North Korea now? I would argue it's the fact that North Korea and South Korea literally have come together, that North Korea has agreed to certain conditions, that the time and date, the date and the place for this meeting is already in.
And we will cover that summit, absolutely.
Well, but cover it now. Show that we want complete, verifiable, and irreversible denuclearization, that Kim Jong-un has already promised to make certain moves. And it would be a great gesture of goodwill to get these hostages released. But look, the same fact-checking at the Washington Post that everybody here loves to quote, they showed some whoppers by President Obama. Now, you mentioned President Obama. I didn't. I didn't mention the woman who...
I mentioned Obama because Trump mentioned
but
Obama.
He had a lot of whoppers that mattered to people when he said he came right after out of Benghazi and said it was an act of terrorism. No, he didn't.
We covered
the janitors in the Capitol got it.
We absolutely covered them.
That you can keep your plan. Look, every president is looked upon for everything they're communicating to the American people. The president's approval ratings are up. I think the right direction number is up because people see progress and security. And I would say to you, they're also tired of him being picked upon every single day. What you're telling America is important to them is not what America is telling your pollsters is important to
Kellyanne Conway, thank you so much.
For
we appreciate
me.
Your time. How are questions about President Trump's credibility affecting lawmakers in his own party? We'll talk to the top Senate Republican Roy Blunt next.